A what-if analysis does exactly what it sounds like. It answers the question, what if we did this? Or what if we did that? By tweaking certain variables within a scenario. In some settings, it's also known as a sensitivity analysis because we're checking our model's level of sensitivity to change. You may have seen the what-if analysis command on your Excel data tab before. Let's practice using it to manage our budget for next month. On this spreadsheet, we have our income at the top, the expenses we expect to incur. With all that, we expect to save $210 at the end of the month, but we were hoping to be a bit more financially responsible by saving about 10% of our monthly income. Here's a very simple application of the What If Analysis menu. Let's go to the menu here. And first, let's go to the Goal Seek option. Since we know the goal we're trying to get to, we can ask Excel to work backwards by adjusting a specified variable. We want cell B17 to be 10%. So we want to set that cell, B17, to a value of 10% or 0.10 by adjusting one of the other cells. Of course, it makes sense to offer one of the expenses that we have some control over. So how about dining out? We click on that cell. So we're asking Excel, can you change B11 to make this value 10%? We click OK, and when the calculations are done, we see that we have a negative figure here, so that's not going to work. We'd need to cut back on more than just dining out if we want to get to our goal of 10% savings every month. Let's cancel this goal seek because it's not valid for our purposes. This is where the Scenario Manager comes in handy. We click on Scenario Manager, and let's add our first scenario. The original situation we have here is itself a scenario, so we'd like to save this so that we can come back to it after doing our experiments. Let's click Add and give it a name. We'll call it Original Budget. For the original, we're going to select all the cells that we might consider changing, so that if we do change them in another scenario, we can always revert to these original values. We can designate a maximum of 32 cells as changing cells in any single scenario. Now, we won't change any cells that have formulas because that'll convert them to constant values. So let's say this cell could potentially change. And to select non-adjacent cells, we hold down our control button. If you're using a Mac, you'd hold down the command key on your keyboard. And for adjacent cells, we just click and drag. We can add a comment here, but that's optional. In our case, the scenario name, original budget, is descriptive enough. When we click OK, the scenario values window shows up, and it tells us what's in these selected cells now. Now, we don't change anything for the original scenario. Remember, this is what we want to revert to after doing our experiments. We want to add a second scenario, reducing some of our expenses. So let's click Add here. And again, we give it a name. So let's call this Reduce Fun. This would mean maybe reducing our entertainment, maybe shopping and dining out. And even though we're only looking at changing three values, we'll keep the selection the way it was before for the previous scenario. We'll see why later. Let's add a comment this time. We'll call this Reduce Entertainment, Shopping, and Dining Out. We click OK, and we want to figure out what cells we'll be changing. So entertainment, that's going to be B8. That's this one. We could reduce that to $65. The next cell will be shopping, that's B10. Maybe we could get by on $80. And dining out, let's make that $65 too. We leave the other values unchanged because we're telling Excel that everything else would remain the way we have it in our original scenario. And we want to add one more scenario, one more possibility. We could try to increase our income. Maybe we could work a bit of overtime. So let's call this Increase Income. Let's see what would happen if we increased our income by $150. And we click OK. and the only thing we want to adjust here is the value in B3. Adding 150 here would bring us to 3765.5. And we hit OK. Now we have the three scenarios we created showing up in our scenario manager. To see the result of any scenario that we created, we can either highlight that scenario and click Show, or we can just double-click. Our reduce fund scenario works. We're now saving 10.8% if we reduce these three expenses the way we suggested. But what if we can't or don't want to cut back on our expenses? Let's see if increasing our income by $150 without adjusting our spending gets us to where we want. Let's double-click increase income by $150. And we're just under saving 10%. So this wouldn't be quite enough. Of course, since the income amount is only one variable, that's the value in B3, we could always use the goal seek option that we learned earlier and have Excel work backwards to tell us what our income needs to be to save 10% if we have these same expenses. So let's do that. We want to go back to our original budget and close. Now that we know how to use goal seek, we can set cell B17 to a value of 10% by changing this cell, the income. And Excel calculates that if our income were $3,783, with these same expenses, we'd be able to put away 10%. We can click OK, and if this is a possibility that we want to consider, we can just edit our increase income scenario and use this figure instead. Here's how we edit. We go back to the increase income, hit edit. We can change this name because it won't be 150 anymore, and hit OK. And let's just reflect the value that our goal seek showed us and click OK. So now this is our increase income. It's now at 10%, and that's a possibility that we might want to look into. Finally, we can save all these scenarios that we created for a side-by-side comparison by doing a scenario manager summary. Let's get back in there and click summary. The cells that we want to display in our summary are already highlighted. If we're happy with showing all the cells, then we just hit OK. And what this does is to create a new worksheet that shows what our budget looks like now. That's in white. And the three scenarios we created are showing in gray. Just below, we see the elements of each scenario. Let's make that a bit more readable. And here we have it. Here's the summary. This was our original scenario that only had a savings of 5.8%. And here are the two adjusted scenarios, one where we reduced some of our expenses and this one where we increased our income. And there we have it. Once you're comfortable with these two sensitivity analysis tools, you can explore the third option under the What If Analysis menu. That's the data table. Visit our website to learn even more cool ways to manage numbers with Excel.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.